Previously on Supergroup. After touching down in Vegas, the band got off to a rocky start at rehearsal.
Bad, predictable. It just sounded like old guy rock.
We haven't got time to explore 1,000 ideas from each person.
Problems escalated when drummer Jason Bonham had to leave for another gig.
I leave today, I come back Sunday.
Oh, to shake things up, Doc brought in a beatboxing replacement. Sending the band into a tizzy.
Shut the door, it sucks.
And fueling tensions between Doc and Baz.
It's bull.
Despite the tantrums, the band finally agreed on a name.
What are we?
Oh my God, Fist.
With their new name came their first original song.
Deep in the darkness, in the universe of hate.
Soon, Baz's obsession with his masterpiece clashed with Evan's need for a night on the town.
Would you just let me rock?
Sebastian. Ted Nugent.
Leaving Jason wondering what he was coming home to.
Are we recording an album? Are we recording a song? Has the band left? Am I the only surviving member?
And I'm the elder statesman here. The guys can go out and they can dry hump statues on the strip all night long if they want. But at some point, we have to get productive. And I think I'm going to have to go in there with that crowbar, too.
Let me get out of the way first.
Twice as loud as that.
But not as romantic.
I give Ted a lot of respect because he's my elder, but Ted needs to learn a little respect.
Hey, Evan, we want your creative juices.
Yeah, I got some creative juices for you.
Take It Back really worked incredibly between all of us. We don't need some dude sitting here judging us. We know how to do this. This is our craft.
Now, did you lay this down again?
Or you no, let me play it for you.
Okay.
Sit there, dude.
After listening to what they came up with, I personally didn't feel that it was where it should be. I wanted to see something that was totally different than what everybody would expect it to be. And so far it hasn't.
Demo.
Yeah, I mean, I'd like to see a little bit more.
We're trying.
Yeah, no, I mean, it's a great track if it was 1982, okay? It's not a great track for today.
I don't think that Doc can ever see me as anything but the lead singer Skid Row.
I saw Sebastian's face when Doc walked in the room the first day. It was like he saw a ghost.
There was something between Doc and Bon Jovi and Skid Row and Sebastian where Sebastian became a huge, big, famous star but kind of got f***ed over pretty bad. The whole thing that went down with you and Sebastian early on with him designing his production deal with you, you know, it's upsetting to me.
It was John Bon Jovi putting together the Skid Row project and taking them on tour and signing them to Bon Jovi.
They signed to Bon Jovi.
Not to Doc McGee. Bon Jovi single-handedly broke that band. They put him on the road with him for 2 years,
financed it, that he did all kinds of things for him. Was he rewarded? Yes. Was I rewarded? Yes.
When I met Sebastian, you know, he'd sold 5 million records and he had no money.
I put the kid in the band. I loaned him the money to get his house. I've done everything. I treated this kid like one of my own.
Sebastian will blame everybody but himself, of course. He just went out and spent what he wanted to and did what he wanted to do.
Oh, you ask him how he feels. It'd just be great for you guys to have a chance to talk.
Hi, guys.
Morning.
It's been a huge day today. So where's Sebastian? Where's Evan?
Sebastian's showering.
I'm going to go get Sebastian out of the shower then. You have to get this going right now.
That's all you.
Sebastian. Hello, darling.
Hey.
We've got a big day today. I need you downstairs. We've got to get ready.
I have to take a shower, all right? That's reality.
But we really...
I haven't had a shower.
No, we have a huge day today. Well, hurry. Get in the shower,
please. You don't want Say I'm gonna take a shower? What kind of publicity firm is that?
I do want you to take a shower, but immediately, right now. We've got a lot of stuff to do today. I'm gonna tell you when you get downstairs. We've got the graphic artist here.
I gotta go do some push-ups and sit-ups. This is what I do every day.
I need you downstairs. I don't need you to do push-ups and sit-ups. I need you to take a shower. Okay. I need you downstairs. Okay, thank you.
Okay. Watch this. Watch me go do the sit-ups now. A man's gotta do what a man's gotta do.
When I have a concert to do, I go into training mode. It's the final
countdown. I don't think people realize how athletic rock and roll is.
Like, it's a physical thing, man, really. You have to be aerobically in shape to kick ass on stage.
If I was a publicist, I would make my lead singer do that. What the?
The graphic designers are waiting for us. Fist, come together as one. This is Scott and Chris. They're from AMI Studios. They are amazing graphic designers. They've got some comic background as well. I know you guys like comic books.
We met up with some graphic artists today and talked to them about ideas for a logo for FIST.
That hand on the front, just after just punching the crap out of something, it's kind of bloody and it just says fist.
Killer. Also, his thing about the eagle claw, gotta see that. Yeah. That is killer.
Two of his fingers are talons.
Well, maybe you end up with something that's more like the Teamsters or something like that, mm-hmm. Like where you have the ribbon, you have a shield.
Definitely.
And if you want imagery, you can have stuff like stuff that we care about. You know, you could have like on the one actually like two guitars crossed. Yeah, or you know, and you could have on this side like a coffee cup.
It's really hard to say, oh, by the way, that idea sucks. Like a coffee cup with cross guitars is, you know, that's fist.
Nice.
Oh my God.
It's gonna be one of those things we're all gonna look at it intuitively, know yes or no, period.
Okay, how do you guys feel about the photographer, Ross Halpin?
Nice.
He's coming today. He's flying in from England just for you guys to shoot today, and he's got today.
Cool.
When they said Ross Halpin's actually coming in from London to shoot you guys, it kind of made me really see how serious it is because he's the best.
You guys are a super group, so we're going to work on sort of a
superhero.
Okay,
I'm going running now then.
You can run.
Yeah, you guys don't get it.
I'm not
going. I'm going running now. I'm not ready.
Listen, you guys got upset with us because you didn't have flyers at a club. That isn't as important as being a band and getting your photographs taken and
I don't want to take a picture when I'm out of shape. Do you understand that?
No one's going to notice. Go take a shower. How are you going to get in?
Sebastian, don't do it. Just sing. He doesn't have to be all the time Sebastian Bach.
Sebastian?
Yeah?
Hey. Can we talk for a second?
Talk all you want.
We just have a really limited amount of time. And
cool.
So do individuals
first with the other four guys.
Vocation's not here.
Huh?
Vocation's not here.
Well, then you're going to wait, or you can get another singer.
What's the problem?
I know how to do this. I need to go running. I didn't go running yesterday. It's 11:30 a.m. I'm going for a f***ing run. We'll begin this at 12:15.
How long are you going to go running?
I don't know. Like 40 minutes? Whatever, man. You know, you guys got Joey Fatone. That's not the look I'm going for. I gotta be in shape. What the
keep f- yelling
because
at
because I have to argue with you guys
you
to do
argue.
My job.
You're starting an argument.
This is my job.
No one's arguing.
Yeah, but I
Sebastian,
what?
You know what? If you said I need 40 minutes,
I did. I've been pleading.
Stop yelling at me. Stop yelling
at me. Get out of my room.
Please stop yelling at
me. Get the out of my room, all right? Don't tell me what to do. Go manage a Backstreet Boys.
They're still selling records.
In this decade.
Coming up on Supergroup.
I'll be back at 12:15.
Sebastian's prima donna act kicks into overdrive.
He's being like a big diva.
But he finally meets his match at the photo shoot.
Scumbag, don't you know?
Just let me do what I need to do. Do I tell you how to sing? You, Ross!
I don't give a about the photo session. I want to go on a run.
The Heatherette styling team is here.
Oh, for the photo shoot.
Yeah. So we have Sebastian's showering now, or he's off running?
I don't know.
All right, because if it's good, if he's off running, I got the bag of food out of my hair.
Scott, I'm going to f***ing Sebastian resign today. If he wants to get in the car, it's rolling. And if he doesn't want to get in the car, it's still rolling.
People are angry at me. I mean, what the f***? Don't go running. Don't work out. I'll be back at 12:15. Is that all right?
He's being like a big diva, like, I have to go running right now, and the photo shoot's now gonna be 2.5 hours late.
What's the problem with him?
I don't know, I guess he's gonna do what he's gonna do until Ted tells him otherwise.
We're gonna get back at 6 from this photo shoot, and everybody's gonna wanna eat dinner, and it's gonna be 7:30, and they're gonna go, well, how come we haven't rehearsed, and why don't we even record it? I was his biggest supporter yesterday, and today I'm just like, you know what?
Any runner knows that if you take one day off, you lose like 2 days training. So I have a gig in like 8 days and I'm training for my gig and nobody's gonna with that.
Dress. Or at least looking at the clothing.
I wanna go see who
Heatherette.
What's Heatherette?
Heatherette is probably the hottest design team out there right now. And they were brought in to really give the band an updated look.
Hi, guys.
I don't know who Heatherette is. They were just two gay guys who had a bunch of trashy vaudeville clothing. I wasn't going to wear anything I didn't like.
You know what? I'm not going to say no, but I'll say no.
If nothing else, the guy had a cool cowboy hat for me to wear.
I love that.
I like that.
Scott's going to go, I'm not wearing any of this. If you don't like it, then I'm not going to be in the photo shoot.
Throw it over one shoulder.
That's not going to happen.
So cute.
I'm not dressing like a superhero. They're never going to get me to wear something that I wouldn't normally wear. No.
I tell you straight up.
What about the denim vibe?
Not.
What you mean? I'm not wearing those.
I'm English.
I think I'm gonna stick with the jeans.
I you look
wow.
You know,
like I need my balls magnified. They're dragging on the cement, making
very
dogs pump
power.
Air as we speak. You know what I mean, Richie Booby?
I love it.
I think they're adorable. I used to hang out with Truman Capote and Andy Warhol. So what do you got that's gonna catch me off guard? What do you? I tell you what you got. You got nothing.
Nah.
Ooh, that's a good one.
A gay aborigine. I love it. Change the name of the band, quick.
I felt exhilarated coming back from my run. I felt proud of myself for standing up for what I believe in and standing up for my craft. Today I had to fight for everything I believe in. Just the same as yesterday, just the same as tomorrow.
The photo shoot's now going to be 2.5 hours late because he had to go running and he had to blow dry his hair and he has to now try on all the clothes and he's going to do his makeup. Guys, you have to guide him.
We're working on it.
Show him the clothes.
The only downside of having Sebastian in the band is that it's gonna, people are going to judge it so hard on how it looks.
If he looks like a douche, we'll tell him. So tell him.
It's New York City. And like he walked down in that outfit today, and I was just, my heartburn acted up first. Before I could even say anything, my nodge had kicked in.
You're like a Space 1999.
Sebastian in that jumpsuit makes the village people look straight. Let's put it that way. I'd go a little harder than that.
Dude, we're
serious. I have no idea why he was so into that jumpsuit.
I'm a glam.
Can we go a little more, man?
You're feeling like
it's embarrassing. It's embarrassing for me.
Okay, so I guess I'm getting this all.
Yeah, I think that's hot. That's a no. Well, he can't dress like he's in Poison.
Right.
Okay, because it's bad enough he's Sebastian Bach.
Evan thought that it was way too glam, and so did everybody. Dig it, dude. So they outvoted me.
Everything's down there.
Yeah?
Yep.
But it's like new eyeliner, right? Because if you use somebody else's, you get eye infection, you know? Should I use mine or?
Bring yours.
Yeah.
Oh, there he is.
Sebastian, hello.
I'm not really excited about the photo shoot because our photographer, Ross, he's a pain in the ass. He's just a ball buster.
Hey, I'm kind of disappointed. You guys all said you were such a and you're acting pretty nice.
Yeah, no, no, no. Because we're on TV. He takes
it's great early.
Pictures. He's a
no.
Pain in the
no, no, I am a but
we didn't get that. Great pitches.
It wasn't like they just had some guy come out from LA and shoot us. They flew Ross in from London. If you have Ross shoot you, you know your photos are gonna come out great.
One, two, three. Good, hold it. That's good. Yeah, that's it. Good. One, two, three. Keep it there.
The name of the band is Fist.
So you're gonna say you fisted someone?
No, that's the name of our band.
That's exactly what my thing was.
I don't like the shadow behind my legs.
I'm just trying to get one of the whole thing. Just let me do what I need to do. I'll tell you how to sing.
After the week we've had, it's really nice to see somebody else work with the talent and give them a hard time.
I never liked it.
Sebastian, you're semi-professional at what you do.
If I was photographing somebody, I'd want them to feel good and happy and positive. He does not do that for me.
Gentlemen.
All the way, halfway.
You know, Sebastian, without being awful, you don't have the body for it.
What do you mean?
You don't have, you're not what you were.
Now I'm ready to do pictures.
No, I mean...
I think Ross Halpin just likes to get other people's skin, and that's his Napoleon complex. Of course he wants to take a stab at Sebastian. You know, Sebastian's a rock star and a sex symbol, and he's a little twerp.
Ivan, that's so Nikki Six. What? All this is like so bad Motley
crew. I've never even seen Motley.
Really? Every photo of Motley's like this.
You're
like,
merciless,
oh.
You venomous... sucker.
Why do all Americans feel the need?
You lie to me? Exactly.
Hey, I don't like it. I don't like claim
family.
Anyway, okay. Sebastian, do you want to do some of your silly fists? Just to sort of give it, yeah, that's it, perfect. Look ridiculous.
Right?
Yeah, one, two, three. Okay, Sebastian, that's it. How American
was real, though.
If they don't take it seriously, then why would anybody else?
You, Ross!
Still to come on Supergroup, Baz makes a Nugent classic his own, causing Uncle Ted extreme intestinal distress.
Puke.
Plus, when Jason loses feeling in his hand,
numbness back in hands.
A visit to the emergency room ends rehearsal and puts the band's final performance in question.
I got annoyed with Doc about something, and it turned into a conversation about you.
Like what?
I told Doc today, you know, I think he has to have a conversation with Sebastian that's gonna clear the air, and I feel protective of Sebastian. I'm kind of like Big Brother. I told Doc, you know, Sebastian looks up at you because you're the guy who put him on the stage, and I said, I know that you have your story about what happened with Skid Row. I go, and he denied the whole thing. He goes, well, you know, he did a deal with Bon Jovi, but I had no piece of that. And I go, but he did it on camera. And I go, you know what, Doc, it makes you feel good to believe that. But I told him, I said, dude, it's hard for Sebastian to have you around. I said, I can't.
It is.
And I told him, as a band member, I can't have you around freaked out and upset because he's worried that you're going to rip him off again.
I thought up the name of this band. You know, and he's probably got a
hobby written already.
Evan is like... a true rock and roller, and he looks at a rock band like a gang.
I go, dude, what about when I met Sebastian in like 90-something?
He was broke.
And he was broke. I live in a $300 a month apartment. I was gonna bring meat over for your barbecue, you know?
He seems to be extremely protective of me, and it's really heartening, and it's really cool. You know?
When we opened up for Eddie Van Halen, first thing Eddie Van, I go, hey man, nice to meet you. He goes, hey man, how's about the deal you did with Bon Jovi, dude? Oh. First thing he said, Eddie Van Halen.
I just feel like Doc has something, not against me, but I just feel this wall.
It's now 3 o'clock in the afternoon. Like walking around and not really getting anything done. We need to kind of remember what we are actually doing here, which is we're supposed to be creating some music.
You know that sacred piece of music I call Stranglehold? When we finished it, the producer said, quote, with a little bit of editing, it'll be great. And I said, whoa, whoa, whoa. He goes, well, you went on and on. I went, yeah. You would edit some of those miraculous notes I play? I said, I dare you.
I've been listening to Stranglehold for almost 30 years. I was freaking out standing there playing that. This is like it was, you know, back in 1981 when me and my friends used to just jam, except now I'm doing it with Ted Nugent.
So my point is you already stand up for what you believe in, but always stand up for what you believe in. Never, if you feel it, it's sacred, it's sacred.
I don't throw the word love around like some stoned hippie. And I do love people who show goodwill and decency, especially in a collaborative effort with Uncle Ted for the musical Beast. I love Sebastian. I always have. But his enthusiasm and lust for life oftentimes does manifest itself as an Achilles heel. He expresses quite clearly how he loves Cat Scratch Fever and Free For All and Stranglehold. And as we were jamming on those songs last night, his enthusiasm became such a firestorm of excitement that he squalored the vocals. And he pretty much destroyed the songs that he said he loved.
Watch it tonight. Wait, that's crazy. Citrusy. It's opening up my pores like orange juice. Like, wow. Smooth.
You can't put a different wine in the same glass as a previous wine. It's disgraceful to the grape.
I gotta get some for Scott Ian. Dude, let me just tell you, this is fine ass. It's better than what you're drinking. Here, I want you to taste it.
Oh, wait.
Just try.
This is $2 chuck, dude. Charles Shaw. This is like...
It's actually really good,
this
though.
This seriously costs $5 at Trader Joe's.
$2 chuck?
That's what it's called. It's Charles Shaw.
Great. Me and Doc have been through some things that are incredibly fun and some things that are not so fun, and I don't really want some of the not-so-fun things to be part of the show.
Here, I want to come here.
That's why I pulled him aside.
I just want to talk to Doc for a second.
People like you and people like me, they don't come around all the time. Like, they're not all over the place.
When you lose people like this, you go, who's left that I love? You're one of the guys that I love.
You know, you're
And Sebastian and I have always had a good relationship. So I don't know where any of this came from.
My life, let's just move.
Well, that's
right.
That's what I said.
Right?
I'm with you. I didn't bring it up. Evan brought it up.
I know.
The Evan confrontation was, I don't think was addressed to me. It may have been. I think it was addressed to the whole situation.
I love you, man. I told you that one first. I told you first, man.
He's a tough cookie, Doc McGee. Sometimes you can't tell what he's thinking. That's all I'll say about that. All right. Have a seat.
No, that's always good when you got a lot of carcass.
Next.
Sebastian.
Sebastian demonstrates how to get good press.
Leave me the alone, man.
She's a big fan. I just don't want you to piss her off.
And shows the band how to open a show.
Wow.
Plus, the ladies begin to hit town.
I missed you.
All that when Supergroup returns.
Good morning, Scott.
Good morning. Our bass player, Evan Seinfeld, had a flight to New York late last night, and he's gone for the day. So I think we're just going to use the rest of the day today to work out the kinks for the show.
It's been way too Spinal Tappy of us sitting around stroking our coming up with a name. And though we're playing with Fist, I'm not in love with
me
it.
Me neither.
And I'm in love with the band. I'm in love with the music, but I ain't in love with the name.
I'm with you.
Sounds too dirty, white boy, greaseball hippie. We've got to come up with a name that even at some point accurately describes something about us. So we better get cracking on that.
You know what?
Did you say mongrel was used?
But I was thinking raw dog.
I stole my first name, Amboy Dukes. There was other bands before me. There was one in Michigan. It was a black soul outfit that had disbanded 7 or 8 years earlier.
Disband.
Just bad, that bad, every bad.
Just thinking, Fist is not, it's not a great name, dude. It's not. It's really, actually, I hate it now. Now that I really, you want to be honest? I hate that
Good morning, bathing beauty. How you feeling?
What's up, how's it going?
Oh, it's good. Yay.
Cool.
So I have my good friend, Chelsea Carter, from the AP and the ASAP.
Oh, cool.
Largest news organization in the world, and she's a really big fan.
Right,
so she's really excited about interviewing you.
Excellent.
Are you up for it?
Yeah.
Yay.
Absolutely.
Okay, thank you so much.
It's not a TV interview.
No, but just... there is going to be a photographer coming in about an hour.
In about an hour. So if you get a chance to get things together.
Okay, I'm going running today.
Okay, well, if you don't want photos taken, then we don't take photos. You don't need your...
No, I'm saying if I could go running and then do photos, that'd be killer.
Okay.
Like, if you want me to do pictures, I'll go get in the shower and blow dry my hair and blah, blah, blah. If I could, I'll do a interview right now.
Okay. Well, let's get the interview handled while you're feeling jovial. And just so you know, she's very, very, very important to me. Like,
right on.
My business, everything. She's someone that I would want to be treated really well.
You got it.
Okay. Thank you.
No problem.
All right. Sebastian and I definitely have a little bit of a headbutting thing, and I don't know where that comes from.
Sebastian, I gotta figure out where
Okay.
He was out here, and that's where he wanted to do the interview, but he has since left. Sebastian's particularly touchy.
Okay.
Yeah. But you never know. Sometimes he's great, and sometimes he's not. You know, we'll see.
So we know what version of Sebastian I'm getting today?
I think he's in a much better mood today than yesterday. Sebastian? Sebastian? Oh, okay, do you want to... You don't have a shirt on?
Leave me the f*** alone. Yeah, you know what? I gotta go to the bathroom. So you're gonna have to give me like 5 minutes. That's reality.
Is that really him?
Yes. All right, let me go see how the bathroom's going.
Okay.
Be right back. Sebastian?
Yes, I'll be up the pool in 1 second.
She's a big fan. I just don't want you to piss her off.
Just leave me the alone. So now there's not one toilet in the whole house that works. None.
Unbelievable.
I guess my thing was staying musically relevant. Because you are in a band and doing this thing with guys who have also, and forgive the way this is phrased, had their big heydays.
Okay, can I say something?
Oh, feel free.
I got a top 20 album this month. Is that not relevant, having a top 20 album on Billboard? The thing is, I am what I am. I'm just a singer. You know, if you like it, great. If you don't, f*** off. I don't give a f***. My publicist, she just tried to, like, get me aside and prepare me to talk to you. I don't need to prepare to talk to anybody. I don't contrive my answers. I'll talk to you. I don't need to think of what I'm gonna say. I don't need to plan it out. To me, being the youth gone wild when I was 19 is the same as being Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde when I'm 30.
So no acting for the cameras when you know they're on, no kind of doing things that you wouldn't typically do knowing
Well, I
on.
Bite my tongue a little more than I would.
Really?
Believe it or not.
So you are being you, and this is really real. What we're seeing
what
is really Sebastian Bach.
I don't know, whatever you, it is what it is.
I don't wake up and go, who am I gonna be? Like, I don't, you know. I mean, if I'm playing a role on theater or something, you know, that's it. I just don't know how to answer all these questions.
Okay, bye. Thank you.
Oh, yeah. Numbness, back in hands.
Hi, my name is Jason Bonham. I'm a drummer. They told me to give you a call regarding some pain and numbness in my thumb whilst playing the drums and some wrist aching. And if you can give me a call back at your earliest convenience.
We go on stage, lights are black.
We, the unnamed supergroup, nobody knows anything about us outside of really this house. So we just need to open with something that's just gonna kick everyone's ass.
Hey, Scott, here's the intro that I use.
The audience noise, you hear that? It's wiggle. It's like.
Wow.
Look, like when you do something he likes, it gets like you don't know what he's turning into, the Hulk. It just gets so. I'm like, is he gonna kill me?
Stakes are high and it's a weather. It's in the air tonight. I think that's a good intro.
I love it though. He gets so genuinely excited.
And I suggest that we go in to Take It Back next.
Yeah, we got it.
Because then we're a cover band if we don't.
Right. All right, I'm running.
Where are you going? Oh, you're getting your lady.
I gotta go pick her up now.
I'm actually going to.
Is she staying here tonight? You are a lucky man.
I'm actually going. I'm going to the hospital now, so well, he's going there. I want to go to the hospital and get my an MRI done on my hand.
What's wrong with your hand?
I keep getting my hand goes going numb when I'm playing.
What the? You sure it's not from this?
Maybe that's been a while.
I'm not a doctor, but I know there's something going on here. And today it wasn't getting better. It was actually getting worse. It feels not right.
Coming up, Jason gets the diagnosis for his mysterious injury.
Can I have time to get some x-rays of the wrist?
Yeah.
We'll go from there.
Plus,
Rob Cavallo.
Doc calls in a big-time producer to critique the band's new masterpiece.
Not that these five musical geniuses would need a producer. If I go into the guys and say, hey, Rob Cavallo thinks this blows.
I'll hear the song and check it out.
I'm going to pick up my lady at the airport. I wanted her to be here from the start because I think she would have just as much fun just like sharing this with me and like hanging out and just getting to watch everything. So, yeah, I'm excited for her to be here.
I missed you.
It's so good to see you. Let's get out of here. Pearl's a rocker. Her dad is Meatloaf. So she's grown up her whole life, you know, surrounded by rock music and on tour buses. And she's toured herself for 12 years. But if you came here and I, my, we had switched personalities and I was Ted Nugent then.
Are you still jamming today more?
Yeah, I'm sure, okay. As long as everyone's there.
I want to watch.
She knows what I'm doing. She knows everything that I'm doing. When I call her up in the morning from wherever, she knows. She's been there. She's played there 4 times. She knows the Denny's that I'm eating breakfast in, you know? I mean, she knows everything.
I just can't wait to see the house.
If Liberace took a dump, this would be it.
Is that it?
Casa del Supergroup.
That is horrible. Horrible. Horrible.
Look at this.
It's gorgeous. Hi.
Paula has a very good idea, certainly about Sebastian and Ted Nugent. She's known Ted since she was a little girl, and she was a big fan of Skid Row and Sebastian and has met Sebastian.
I guess now Jason is at the hospital getting an MRI on his hand because it's going numb as he's playing.
Hey.
Holy moly! Curly Dad!
Hi.
How's Dad?
He's good.
What's up, Mom?
How you doing?
Your dad's wild.
Dude, I want my chick to be here.
Tomorrow, right?
I don't know. Not soon enough.
Did Jason get back yet?
He's at the hospital.
Yeah.
Jason.
Hi,
that's you,
man.
How
are
you,
Sassy?
What's going on?
I'm a drummer. I'm playing a band called Foreigner.
Not Foreigner. Foreigner.
Yeah, Foreigner.
Really?
Yeah. I'd say about 2 weeks ago now, from continuing playing the hi-hat, I would get the tingly hand, kind of the fatness finger.
Can I have Tony get some x-rays of the wrist?
And, yeah.
And we'll go from there.
Okay.
All right, that's it.
No.
Say hi to my lady.
Hello, oh, ma'am. Hello. You are? Pearl. Pearl, hiya, Pearl.
Dude, that's Pearl.
You glow. Where are you from?
You know where Dad is?
New Yorker? Yeah. Hey. We've met before?
Uh-huh.
Where? See, I try to forget things.
Hey, Pearl.
No, nothing's bad.
I know. Get out. Oh, the meatloaf Pearl. Hell yeah. See, you've grown. I can't keep up with that growth factor. My, you've turned into a lovely young lady. Thank you, Ted. How is Dad and everybody? He's good, yeah. Nicely done, Pearl. Thanks, man. Nicely done. That's cute. The old loaf can really squirt out some good I like that.
What's up? How's it going?
We want you to do radio for us tomorrow. Would you do that?
No problem. Not early in the morning.
9:15.
No, I don't do that. I'll do it on the phone, maybe. I f***ing...
And you guys want us to drive people to the show on Sunday, so that's the way to do it. Well, you know, the biggest audiences are in the morning for radio.
Okay.
And
I know.
It's to drive
town.
People to come see the show.
Okay, really well, if I'm on the radio down. At 9 tomorrow morning, I'm not going out tonight.
Okay.
Welcome to rock and roll reality.
Happened. These people that I respect so much are starting to respect us more and more. We've had one-on-one with each of them and, you know, able to talk and, you know, where we are. And so they appreciate more where we're coming from.
I don't know if you know this, but Rhino Atlantic just released a compilation record called Monster Ballads, the Platinum Collection. You know, it's cringeworthy, you know. But the commercial is me singing I Remember You.
Really?
Yeah, that's the commercial. And it just debuted on the Billboard chart this week, on the top 200 album chart at number 18.
That's hot.
Why don't you guys do a ballad?
Why can't you record like that?
Ask Ted Nugent. Ask Scott Ian if he wants to do a ballad.
No,
not
a ballad.
That's like a rock ballad.
That's my
forte.
Yeah. That's what I do.
Then write the song and sing it the way you want to.
You know what? I feel uncomfortable telling the band, hey, man, I think we should do a ballad. I don't know why, because I just... Because they're all going to go, no.
Are you sure, though?
What?
I think everyone's here to try something new.
Like showing the difference, the change over years. Like, that's huge. I would love to see Sebastian sing a ballad, only because it's not what you'd expect from him. It's not what you'd expect from this band.
What do you guys feel about, you know, maybe a ballad? Not a ballad, but a slower, no way? not even going to consider.
I told you.
Yeah, Sebastian. Because
I love singing
anyway.
Ballads.
Hey, you want to do a ballad?
A rock ballad.
A rock ballad.
What'd I tell you?
Well, we tried.
I told you. Jay, do you want to make the case? So
well, no. Let's.
You guys just hear him out, though.
No, no.
18 Alive, dude. I can sing it great.
You get an older.
He's not into it.
There are too many variables with five different people. You're not going to get a bad song. You're not going to get a bad image out of this if you give yourself into the process.
Rob Cavallo.
Hey, Dr.
G. I called. Rob Cavallo is a producer and a good friend. He's a very, very talented song guy. They have to write a song for this, and we're doing a show next Sunday. Not that these five musical geniuses would need a producer. I think it's better, you know, if I have some ammunition to go into the guys and say, hey, Rob Cavallo thinks this blows.
I'll hear the song and check it out.
In the process of making a record, artists have a tendency to gravitate to where they're at or where they've been. And one of the jobs of the producer and the manager is to take them a little bit out of their element. So that's what Rob does. Let me get you the MP3 of it.
Sounds good.
How's your hand?
He just said it's nerve endings. He said there's some nerve. He said you're either pinching a nerve, but now they get. He said, how long have you got? And I'm like, why? He goes, well, we need a week of testing with like.
Jason's hand is hurting him, and I just hope he's all right.
It's a week now before the show. This is something that I'm really not that sure about.
He's my drummer. I need that hand. I can't kick ass without Jason Bonham's hand.
Next time on Supergroup, a Grammy Award-winning producer delivers a crushing review of the band's first song, Take It Back.
The song is so dated.
I don't know what to think anymore.
But spirits lift when Doc announces a surprise warm-up gig on the Vegas Strip.
You give me the microphone, I'll go anywhere you want.
As the band faces their first public test, the wives arrive.
Where's my chick?
Ooh.
When Evan and his porn star wife stage a photo shoot, Baz's wife Maria joins the fun.
Oh my God. Poke it out. Yeah, like I like it. Yeah.
But the wild times take an ugly turn when Baz's drinking gets out of control.
What the f, man? It's called riding the f out.
You're not playing.
Dude, I'm not playing.
Next time on Supergroup.